I've always had a theory about singles bars. The expressions of the wide-eyed and hopeful people that arrive early every night are not desperate ones. I think that when these people arrive, they have total confidence that they will meet their true love. Except as the night progresses, and as each whiskey sour and martini is poured down their throats, they lose sight of what true love is. And sadly, a disillusioned Juliet goes home with anything in a leisure suit, no matter how hairy. I remember, as a little girl, every Sunday after church I would dress my brother up and play with him like a doll. He didn't like it much, but I had to practice, right? Even at that age, I was obsessed with the arrival of my Romeo. In the meantime, I figured, hey, I might as well sit around and ponder what he looks like or how nice he would treat me. I got a lot of things to do. A lot of places to go. When I went away to college, I still ached for my Romeo. However, something strange happened. I formed a new love. The academic life sparked an interest in me, and for once in my life, something was as important as finding my Romeo. Reading became my passion, and my love branched to the likes of Faulkner, Vonnegut, and Hemingway. Romeo was nowhere to be found. You were out on the couch. My search for Romeo is what brought me to a singles bar one night, a few months after graduation. It was the way that you smiled, and made me know at once that I have to get the fuck out of this town. But every guy I met was an open book, a perverse weirdo. Some weirder than others. And then there was David. He certainly wasn't like the others. Waking up at David's house was strange. After we had been going out for a while, we settled into a routine that was monotonous, to say the least. It wasn't painful, though, our relationship. If anything, it was comfortable. He took care of me, day after day after day. Every Monday after breakfast, we would take a stroll. He liked to look at the buildings, and I liked the park. We compromised and walked up Fifth Avenue. It was harmony. One night, after we'd been going out for a while, he invited me over for dinner. It happened to be my birthday, and he threw me a little surprise party. Dinner was good. and afterwards we talked about work. He said he had presents. God, he gave me this apron to match his. Then all of a sudden he gave me this model of a house. He said he had bought some property in Maine. He said he had designed a house for us. He talked about the garage and the basement and the damn picket fence. He wouldn't shut up.
One laugh in the middle of a struggle. A diamond at the bottom of a puddle. Did you ever stare at the moon till you saw double? I hear you walk away from trouble. Good love, there ain't no denying. Say bad love. Somebody ain't trying. Did you ever walk someplace just to take time, or take the fast road and get going, and then the rules break? There's no mistake. These are precious times. You and I, we walk the line. We walked the line.
All I could say was, goodbye.
I looked in a frying pan. I sang a song. I looked at a dying man. He sang along. We got mountains. Yeah, we got beaches.
A lot has changed. Everything's different, to say the least.
Got love that makes us mad. Love that has to teach us.
Sometimes I wonder where he is or what he's doing.
I looked in front.
No, I don't. Why would I?
Sang a song.
I have a new love, my dog Steinbeck. The way I figure it, I couldn't ask for anything more.
And then the rules break. There's no mistake. These are precious times. You and I, we walk the